Hello aspirants, welcome to Ekamaisakad. Today we are going to discuss about an important international relations aspect, that is Chagos Island. So what is this Chagos Island and why this is in news, and which are all the countries that are in dispute with respect to Chagos? We'll also understand what is India's role on this regard. So let us understand. First thing we need to know, what is this Chagos Island and where it is situated in the map. So here is the Chagos Island. That means it is in the almost southern part of India. That means it is so close to Mauritius. So let us understand, the location is in South Indian Ocean and it is so close to India as well as Mauritius. And we also will understand the dispute actually is here between UK and Mauritius. Let us understand what is the reason why we are discussing this. Britain has recently agreed to transfer sovereignty of Chagos Islands to whom? It is Mauritius. Right, so let us understand more in detail. So what is this Chagos Island and where it is situated? It is situated in the Southern Indian Ocean. It is so close to Mauritius and it is considered to be British overseas territory till the recent time. Okay, so overseas territory. And then we also need to understand, it is so close to Mauritius and Mauritius claims this as part of its archipelago. Almost like you can say archipelago means a chain of volcanic islands. It was formed by a group of almost 60 or so islands, and most of them, if you see, are inhabited. Like you can say around 30 were inhabited, and the largest among this is Diego Garcia. Garcia, where UK and US together has established military base. Let us understand what is the significance of this particular area. So first thing is geostrategic location, because it is located in the Indian Ocean, and you know it is also the area where majority of the sea trade passes through, and any person who is actually vigilant in this region can watch the movements that are passing through Africa, West Asia and also Indian Ocean region. So that is why this region is geostrategically very important. Then as I just told you, in Diego Garcia, there is one US, UK, two countries have established a military base to have a spy on what is, you can say not a spy, but they wanted to keep a watch on what is there in the Indian Ocean, what is going on. And it is also important for environmental and biodiversity reasons. Let us understand what is the Chagos dispute actually about. So first thing we need to know, here the dispute is between UK as well as Mauritius. Right? So what actually happened is, in 16th century, it is Portugal or Portuguese who actually have colonized this. Later on, even Dutch also came, but they didn't settle here. And later on, it came into the hands of French. So French is maintaining this along with Reunion Islands. Now also, if you see, Reunion Islands in the Indian Ocean is the French overseas territory. So along with this, they're also maintaining this. Then what happened after Napoleon's defeat? Napoleon's defeat in the hands of British. So it has to transfer almost in 1814. It has transferred this Chagos archipelago to the British or UK. So in that way, it went into the hands of UK. Then what actually happened? UK, it maintained it as the overseas territory till 1965. And in 1965, this Mauritius as a country became independent. So Mauritius became independent country. At that time, they wanted this to give back to the Mauritius. But what actually happened? UK has already leased this to US. As I told you, one of the island, largest island, that is Diego Garcia, was leased by UK to US on lease. So they don't want to lose hold on this particular region. So they said, nothing, we are not going to give back this to Mauritius, and we are actually controlling this as a overseas territory. So then what actually happened? Mauritius has sought an exchange agreement also. That means it partially agreed UK to maintain this as their overseas territory, but in return they have asked some concessions on US sugar exports so that it will help their country. But for this also, they didn't actually accept. Who didn't accept? It is UK who didn't even accept this proposal from Mauritius. Then what actually happened? Later on, even from the Diego Garcia, the native people of Mauritius or the Chagos archipelago were actually expelled, or you can say they were displaced by UK. Because when they wanted to establish a military base, they have replaced or displaced all the native people of that particular island. That actually has created some resentment among the Mauritius people also. In that way, this actually led to a legal action by Mauritius. So Mauritius have said, It is we people who actually have to control the land, but it is UK who is actually controlling, but still they're also resulting in displacement of native people. In that way, this matter was taken legally by Mauritius against UK, and they want this base to be given to Mauritius. Then it also have went into Permanent Court of Arbitration, which is situated in Hague. So this matter went in 2015, and this ruling was also in the favor of Mauritius against UK only. So they also have said UK has to give back this territory to Mauritius as soon as possible. So UK also said this is a bilateral matter and we will settle it, so we are not going to give back. Then this matter also went to UN General Assembly, and there is voting in which India also voted in favor of Mauritius, because India is always favoring decolonization. India considers UK colonizing Mauritius and it is controlling Chagos Archipelago. So India made it clear, we are not in favor of colonization, so we are supporting decolonization of Mauritius. Then UN General Assembly also voted in favor of Mauritius, and they asked UK to withdraw from the base as soon as possible. Then what actually happened? International Court of Justice also, it has given a ruling in the year 2019 to withdraw UK from this Chagos Archipelago, and it has to be given as soon as possible. So UK also did not agree to this particular verdict of International Court of Justice. Then you need to know this is a UN court, and it is situated also in the Hague, Netherlands, right? So then we also have to understand, then finally what happened is UK and this Mauritius have agreed into an agreement, and where they have agreed, UK will be giving the control of Chagos Island to Mauritius, except this Diego Garcia, because this Diego Garcia was given to UK on given by UK to US on lease, and US is maintaining this as a very important military base, because after 9/11 attacks in USA also, they have used this as a CIA, that means Central Intelligence Agency of USA. So they have made it as an intelligent base to keep a watch on what is going on in the Indian Ocean. So that is the reason they don't want to break this deal of 99 year lease by UK to USA. And in return, Mauritius is saying like, okay, this is fine, but we want some money for the displaced natives, and they have agreed, that means UK have agreed to create a trust fund. So trust fund will be created so that these displaced persons who are from the native Chagos will actually be resettled, and that money will be used for their development. So this is a entire controversy about. Then what is the role of India? India always in favor of decolonization, and we voted in favor of Mauritius. So we always supported Mauritius in this issue because we want peaceful Indian Ocean. Then what is the practice question given? What was the primary reason for expulsion of the indigenous population from Chagos Archipelago in 1960s and 70s? So among these, try to choose the correct option and let me know in the comment section. Then today we have discussed about why UK recently made a decision of giving back Chagos Archipelago to Mauritius. So what is the historical background of the dispute, and what is India's role in this regard, and how this journey went so far, and what is its importance? All this we have discussed in this video. If you like the video and found informative, let me know in the comment section. Thanks for joining. All the very best.